having a senior project was bringing their dogs to the school for a visitation day. My essential question was, how can I bring therapy dogs into the school and what impact could they have on students' mental health? Here's an overview of what's going to be shown in this project, why I decided to do this project, my mentor, research, the project plan, reaching out about the organization, preparing for the day, the visitation day itself, failures, and my final thoughts. Why I decided to do this project. I've always had a love for animals, so when I was thinking what I wanted to do for my project, I definitely wanted to do something with animals, and which made me think of doing something with therapy dogs, which would be beneficial for the students and make an impact. It was also done a few years ago in the past. Someone did this as their senior project and it was very successful. So I wanted to bring it back. And I wanted to increase positive moods in the school. My mentor for my project was Ms. Sullivan. I chose her because I knew she already had a lot of knowledge and information about therapy dogs. She has a service dog of her own named Harry. And she was very helpful throughout my whole project. She gave me a lot of information and helped me along the way. She also helped me choose the best organization because I didn't really know much about the organizations around us, so she provided me with that. And she's also our adjustment counselor at her school, so she has a lot of information on mental health and how dogs can make an impact on that. So research on therapy dogs. When beginning research for my project, I found these impacts therapy dogs have on students, which is include increased students' feelings of connection to their school, temporarily relieves homesickness and stress, improves mood and well-being, decreases anxiety, lowers blood pressure, and also has positive effects on students' academic and social growth. So my achievements for my project, what I hope to achieve for my project and visitation day was a successful day with therapy dogs, the opportunity for students to come and hang out with the dogs for the day, an impact on mental health and boost the mood of students, and also to learn about therapy dogs, the training they go through, and what it's like to own one of your own. So planning for the project, the first thing I needed to do was research different therapy dog locations around me, which, like I said, Ms. Sullivan helped me a lot with that. And once I chose the best organization, my next step was to reach out to them and plan the best time and way to come to the school for a visitation day. And then below there is the email I sent them. So reaching out was probably my biggest struggle. It took a really long time for them to reach back to me, and my first email I sent them was back in November, and I waited a few weeks and never got a response. So then I tried to reach out to them with a different email that they had on their website, and they also didn't get back to me. So then I tried calling them a few times also. I left some messages, and then a few weeks later they finally reached out to me, and that's the text message that we sent. And then we also talked on the phone about the whole plan and planned it there. So about Golfy Dog Organization, that's the organization I chose. It's located in Walpole, and it basically breeds, trains, and raises English-type golden retrievers. And the owner of the organization is Pauline Hogler. She's the one that I talked to and planned it all out with. And the dogs are used for different programs and events, and they go to different schools for students a lot. So it's a perfect organization. Preparing for the visitation day, there wasn't much preparing to do. I just stayed in touch with the organization and made sure the plan was set, and we talked about what we were going to do for that day. And then I just had to get the word out. I had Mr. Ontippy announce it on the morning announcements so that students and staff know about it. And then I planned with Mr. Ardicky when I would be booking the conference room. So here are a few photos from the visitation day. The day went really great. It was a huge success. And the therapy dogs came in with two police dog handlers, which I didn't expect. And it was really cool to see that. And then my initial plan was to have the dogs go in the conference room, and then people could just come in and see them, but we had them walk around the halls and go into different classrooms so that they could give the opportunity for students, if they didn't have a study or free period, to go into the classrooms and see them. So after we walked around the halls and went into classrooms, we brought them back into the conference room, and then we just had, throughout the day, like people coming in and out. So failures and obstacles. My biggest thing was didn't get a response to my emails. It was hard to plan that out. It took a pretty long time to get a response. I think my first email was in November, and then the time they reached back out to me in like February, I think. So my initial plan was to have more than one visitation day, but that didn't work out. I was gonna have one in December, and February and March. And it was also kind of difficult to find a date that worked for the school and the organization. They're really busy, so they didn't have a lot of availability, but we worked it out. So final thoughts. It was a very successful day. It made a really big impact on the students and boosted the moods in the school. And it was also really cool to get the opportunity to talk to the police dog handlers, and they kind of just talk to the students about what it's like for training and what the dogs are like, because they own the dogs, so how the dogs act when they're working and how they act when they're not working. And if I'd known that it was so hard to reach out and get a response, I would have reached out sooner, or I would have gone to the place and talked to them in person. But overall, it was a really fun day and something that should be considered doing again in the future for another senior project. My thank you to Ms. Sullivan for being my mentor and helping me throughout the whole project. She helped me a ton with the organization and just provided me with information that I needed. And then thank you to Mr. Rodicki for helping me book the conference room and getting the word out about my project. Thank you to the two police dog handlers for coming in with the dogs and talking about their experience. And thank you to the Golfy Dog organization for setting this up with me. Sources, questions.